Hey guys, so I'm bringing back, why am I clapping? I'm bringing back the top three videos, and they're always like more than three stuff. I do three things, and then I recommend like two more things. So it's like a, honestly, it's like a top five, but top three just sounds better. So we're gonna go with top 3.5. How we do that? How we got that? So I don't know. I was just feeling inspired. I'm feeling it this week, guys. I'm really feeling it. So I wanted to do a top three loose powder video. I've never done this. I've done my top three foundations in the past, and eventually I will do top three updated foundations. Everyone always wants to hear about the foundations, but I like to do them like at the end of the year, you know, let new releases come out and kind of reference those in a, like my end of the year review. So we're gonna hit some other stuff today. I'm gonna do top three loose powders. So I have affordable alternatives towards the end. We're gonna start, and this is kind of in order. This is a loose order. I mean, certain things get rotated, if you guys get what I mean. That's just the nature of the beast. I won't stick with one thing forever. So when I say something's like my favorite, yes, it's really good. I probably recommend it, but it doesn't mean I'm gonna be glued to it forever. And if I am gonna be glued to it forever, I will let you know. Number one, it's real dirty, like real dirty right now. But clap is gonna get all everywhere. This, I have three containers of, mainly because I keep ending up getting them in like goodie bags and like PR packages, but it's really, really good. I did an Instagram post about this on Valentine's Day. This is what I have on my under eye today and in the past few videos. This is the Derma Blend Setting Powder. It claims to set your makeup for up to 16 hours, and all of their makeup actually claims to up to 16 hours. I've done a review with their foundation, and I also have the tinted version. They have two different shades. I have Cool Beige. They have like two colored shades and the Translucent Original. This stuff's really good. I recently went to New York and I like swatched their whole line, but this stuff, this is not sponsored by the way, really good. Nikki Tutorials recently featured this too in her long wearing makeup video. This is available at Sephora for $27, and there is 1 ounce of powder. Works for everyone, doesn't give you a white cast. It definitely gives you a brighter look, but does not give you that white cast, and it's so finely milled. This one is probably the finest milled powder out of all, and that's why it's my favorite of this video. It gets a little messy because it's like one of those sticker peel off, and then you have holes underneath and you can poke a few holes or do whatever method you want to do to not get too much everywhere. Mine right now is just like free for all. Everything's everywhere in there. I have other ones, and because I have so many, I'm going to be giving one away to you guys in this video. The link will be at the top of the description box. If you guys want to enter, click the link to the Google page and you guys can see all the information needed to win one of those. So it says it can lock your foundation in and your concealer. Sometimes I use it all over my face, but mainly I've been using it to set whatever highlighting concealer I have. I just tap it in with whatever loose brush. This is the one I use. I used one by Valair today. I just pat, looked up, pat, and brush it away. I don't have to bake long, but if you like to bake long, you can do that. It's very, very nice. It looks so natural. It doesn't sink into the fine lines. It doesn't give you that cast. And it works. It also works very well with their products, and it does last forever. It makes them like almost bulletproof, I'll say. You have to go see my old foundation review to kind of see it in action, but it's some good stuff, really good stuff. So that is number one. Number two would be the Kat Von D Translucent Powder. This is the Lock It Setting Powder. This one has a little bit more of a pinky tone to it. They also have smaller ones that are like yellow and I think a peach that are kind of like correcting loose powders. This is also very, very finely milled, and you get a lot. You get 0.67 ounces, so you get the most, I think, in the Derma Blend. The Kat Von D powder retails for $30, and this one might be in my May giveaways. Just a little hint, hint on my anniversary giveaways. This is awesome as well. This I do like to set my whole face with because it has a little bit more of a tint to it. And I switch between all of these as far as what I grab for setting my concealer, and that's mainly what these are used for me, but they are good for other uses as well. This stuff's awesome. This doesn't get everywhere for me. This is a little bit more tamed, but I do have a lot like in the lid right now. This has a little star shape as far as the holes go. It has a natural finish, as it claims. It has micro blurring technology, it's mattifying, all that good stuff. It's very, very good if you don't want to go with a white translucent powder, just in case that maybe you're deeper in skin tone and you don't even want to go that bright, too much bright effect. This one is a nice, safe ground for you, and for all skin tones, actually. I like it a lot. I haven't tried the smaller shades yet, the yellows and all that, but I do really like the Kat Von D one. Next, it's three. Where am I going with this? Third place ties Laura Mercier with the RCMA No Color Translucent Powder. If you haven't heard about this, it's everywhere. It's all over social media, every outlet, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, all of it. This stuff is highly recommended from freelance makeup artists, professionals, and non-professionals like myself, influencers. It's good. It is good for keeping in your kit. You get a lot of it. It definitely looks like, you know, salt. Salt or sugar, flour. And it's good for everyone because it's no color. It definitely is no color. It is finely milled as well. It's great. It has a very long line of good feedback. So I can't say that it's bad anyway. Why it's third, I don't know. I just don't reach for it as much. That's just me. But I like it a lot as far as enough to put it in this video. I would recommend it if you want something more affordable. This is $12. Sometimes you get around like $9. You can get this on Amazon. It's really good if you want a lot of bang for your buck. So that's why that would be number three. And I mean, Laura Mercier is like a staple for a lot of people. I've only owned the travel size in the recent years. When I was starting out on YouTube 8 years ago, I probably bought this maybe a year in. I bought the big one. I didn't know what to do with it back then. Like, I had no clue what to do with it. So I just like slathered it all on my face and I probably looked a hot mess back then. But it's still really good. This one is similar to the Kat Von D. I have this in travel size, so I just use it when I'm traveling. It has that like natural tinted skin tone look, though it's translucent. The Kat Von D runs more neutral. This one runs more yellow. It's not like banana powder yellow, and I'm not really gonna talk about banana powders that much in this video. Maybe that's like a separate one, but you can use this in place of a banana powder if you want to. It's not super yellow though. It's just a staple. Everyone really likes it, and I have no like problems with it either. It just falls number three for me. That's just where it is. So that was 1, 2, 3, 3.5, or you can call it 4 because those two kind of tied. But then I wanted to give you guys an affordable alternative for those who don't want to order on Amazon, don't want to pay $20, $30, $36 for a loose powder. Maybe you run through your powders often, maybe your kids dump it out on the carpet all the time and you don't got time for that. Maybe you just want something you can pick up in store. So drugstore alternative that I recently tried out. It's by e.l.f. This is their Soft Luminance Loose Powder. I think it's like for setting the under eye or something like that. I forgot what like the actual title of it. It's gonna be in the sidebar, so you guys already know. It comes in translucent. I haven't tried the translucent. I tried the Soft Luminance one. It's like a kind of pinky toned, and it has a little bit of shimmer in it. A little bit, nothing too much, nothing too glittery. Wouldn't count as a highlighter in my opinion. But a soft glow, it could be a soft all over powder. That's really good. It's nice and finely milled, and it's very, very affordable. It's probably like $6. e.l.f. be changing the prices sometimes, so I don't know. I can't say everything's $3 or $1 anymore. It's probably like $6. Pretty sure, but I'm wrong. My sidebar has corrected me. It's good. It's good if you want something drugstore. I wouldn't say it beats everything else, and I don't grab for this first, but if I just, you know, don't really care to be messing around with nothing like that, don't want to use those today, I have no problem grabbing this. Some good stuff. You set this on top of their HD Lifting Concealer. Girl. But this shade probably wouldn't work for everyone compared to the other stuff that I named. So there you go. Those are my top 3/5 loose powders. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Links for everything will be down below. Let me know down below or on other social media what else you would like to hear from me, whether it be like liquid lipsticks, brow products, liners, lashes, maybe, who knows. And I will get those done for you guys over time. I won't say ASAP, but over time. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video.